As you are aware, sir, under the Constitution, from the last date on which the resolution was passed by either House of Parliament, the proclamation for the administration taken over by the President would continue to remain in force until the 24th October 2000. Now, this resolution has been brought forward for purpose of continuing the administration by the President in Kerala for a further period. In effect, according to law, the further period would be 6 months, but sir, in view of the reorganization of states and the emergence of the Kerala state from the 1st November 1950, it is a matter for consideration as to whether a new resolution or a new proclamation will be necessary, and the tentative advice that we have received is to the effect that when a state head comes into existence after the 1st November 1950, there will be have to be a new proclamation issued by the President. If a new proclamation is to be issued, then naturally the effect of the present resolution would be to make the President's rule valid for a further period of 1 week only. Whatever it is, sir, under the Constitution, it is necessary that every time after 6 months, when the proclamation is to be further extended, an opportunity should be given to the honorable members of the two houses so that they can know how the administration is being carried on and how it is being carried on during the last 6 months. This would enable them to consider the question as to whether it would be advisable or necessary to extend the period of the proclamation by a further period of 6 months. It is for this reason, sir, that a provision has been made in the Constitution in consonance with which this resolution has been placed before the House, in order to enable the honorable members to understand how the President's rule has been carried on. A pamphlet has been published which gives the information relating to the last 6 months. Now, sir, when the President took over the administration, naturally there were certain problems of a peculiar nature. I am not dealing here with the political problems, but only with the administrative problems as they exist there. There was the problem of procuring food grains from the surplus states. After the advisor took over charge, naturally had to devise certain measures for purposes of bringing the administration to a very high of efficiency. That is the reason why the advisor issued a statement immediately after he arrived in Trivandrum on the 20th March 2000. I would read the very short but important statement that he made, because that would indicate to this House the lines on which, under the guidance of the President, The advisor has carried on the administration during the last 6 months. This is what it is, says the president's rules, which is necessary of a temporary character, will give the people a short respite from politics and will provide an administration impartial, absolutely above party, above case and above creed, and I hope efficient. It will be my special endeavor to implement the schemes included in the 10th five-year plan and to create employment for some at least of our educated employed. He had made a further appeal for cooperation so far as the public is concerned and for harder work so far as the officers are concerned, and thus, sir, he has taken under scrutiny all the acts that have been done by the various departments under his overall supervision and has appointed out how, to a large extent, the administration has become fairly efficient and how he has given his attention to various problems. Now, the first and naturally the most important problem that has to be taken into account is to what extent the 9th five-year plan has been implemented and to what extent the 10th five-year plan has to be placed on a sound footing. Naturally, therefore, these are the two circumstances which we have to take into account, because ultimately all the acts or omissions, if any, will be judged by this particular target, namely to extend the president's rule has succeeded in implementing the plan. After all, you will find, sir, as the advisor has rightly pointed out, that the president's rule has had to come into existence under exceptional circumstances. Now, even if there are certain exceptional circumstances, it is absolutely essential that the continuity of the progress of the nation has to be maintained, and therefore it is not merely an administration in the routine sense of the expression, but we have to carry on the various welfare schemes as they have been envisaged in the 9th five-year plan to the extent that they remain unfinished. I would invite the attention of the honorable members.